Hello, my name is Kainsan Munonye. I'm the application developer, and in this video, we are going to be discussing relationship and referential integrity in relational databases. So I'm not going to be spending time to explain. I'm actually spending time to demonstrate how it works. Now, take a look at the three tables presented in this slide. The first one is the employees table. The second one is the departments table. So I have two tables here, and now this last one is a query. So let's focus on the two tables we have there. This is the list of employees in the company, and these are the departments of the company. Now we have department ID. We have the department's ID also in the department table. So what we are saying is that in a relational database management system, two tables are related using keys. Two tables are related using keys. So what are keys? Key is a unique identifier that identifies a record. So we have primary key and also we have foreign key. Just a second, let me use this pen. So a primary key is a key in a table that uniquely identifies the record. So in the employees table, we have the batch number as our primary key, and in the departments table, we have the ID as the primary key. And now in the employees table, we have a field, the department ID. And that is also a key, but not a key in the employees table. So, since it is a key in the departments table, but not a key in the employees table, but it appears in the employees table, we can say it is a foreign key in the employees table, while it is a primary key in the departments table. So, we can go ahead to define a foreign key as a key in a particular table, but a primary key in another table. Okay, so now the point is we need to present the data in terms of the batch number, the first name, the last name, the department name, and the position. So we want a table, okay, that gives us data selected from the employees table and also the department table. So we have the batch number from the employees table, the first name, the last name, but now the department name is coming from the department table. So the first three columns or fields comes from the employees table, the fourth one comes from the department table, and the position comes from the employees table. I think this is a training engineer. I think that's wrong. This is the right position. So as we demonstrate using Microsoft Access Database, try to take note of how we can explain what relationship and also referential integrity is all about in a database. So let's pitch into the application and start creating these databases here. When you are doing some design, it's good to create your tables in Excel first. Maybe that may help you handle the data well. Let's use agriculturist. Okay, that is what he was. So we have three positions here. Okay, so the first, we want to create these tables in Microsoft Access Database, and we explain what relationship is and also what referential integrity is. So try to follow along and don't fail to pause the video and see how you can get exactly what I'm explaining here. Okay, so I don't really understand why this happens every time. So let's wait for some seconds. I don't know why it has to configure Microsoft Office. I don't know. Maybe I'll check my installation after now. So a little of explanation. For this Excel sheet, take note that this age has been calculated from the date of birth. Okay. In a different video, I will teach you how to do this in Excel, in Microsoft Access, and also in MS SQL Server 2008, because that is the version I'm using, of course, for this two database. So for now, we are not focusing on these calculations here. So the first thing we are going to do is to create a database, and maybe we give the database a name. I don't really know why it's taking so much time, but let me go ahead to open it a second time. Microsoft Office Access 2010. I don't get it. Alright, so this is the Microsoft Access window. So just go ahead to give your database a name. Let me just call it RelationDB, and just go ahead and click on create. The directory it is saving in my document folder, and this is it. So the first thing you have here is table one, but what we want to create is employees table. So let's reduce this to this size. We also reduce this to this size so that we'll be able to see what we are doing. So here is table one, and we want to save it as employees. TBL is always good to use TBL as prefix to the names of your tables. So TBL employees. Okay, and that is fine. It's better for you to go to the datasheet view to be able to create this table. So just go to view, and to the design view, and go to the design view. So here you will specify your fields. The first field there is the batch number, and it is a text. Okay, it's text. The second one is the first name, is also text, and we have last name is also text. Maybe I'll just maximize this so that you'll be able to see. So created three: batch number, first name, and last name. Okay, so we go ahead to create department ID, date of birth, age, and position. Department ID is a text. Date of birth, I call it DOB, and this is date and time. Age, it should be our number, and then position. Is test. Now we have the key here, meaning that the batch number has been selected as our primary key. So we go ahead to create another table. So click on the create tab and just click on table, right click, let's save us, and we are giving it a name, TBL department. I say you need to use the prefix of TBL for all your tables. So TBL department, and also name your table in plural because it contains several pieces, several departments for this particular one. The TBL department, go back to view and click on design view, and go ahead to create three fields: department ID, name, and manager. So we have ID, name, and manager. So let's call this department name. It's always good not to use spaces in the names of the field. So we have ID, we have department's name, we have manager, meaning the head of this department. Or let's just call it a HOD. Everything is okay. No ID is not number. It is text as well. And that is just fine. So the next thing we do is to create the last table, and that is now here it comes. We only have two tables. The last one is a query. So these two tables here, let's insert this data first into these two tables. So go ahead to copy your data from Excel, and then for the employees, go to the data sheet view. Yes, save, and then we go ahead to paste. Yes, we are pasting the three records. For the department, the same thing. Go to the data sheet view, that is the first view here, and then it prompts you for you to save the table. And right, you save your table. We want to copy these two items from the department's table, and we are going to paste here. Please try to follow along. If you have difficulties, try to make a comment there and tell me the problems you're having, and I'll be there to explain to you. Alright, so we have created two tables in Microsoft Access. Okay, save everything. And then the next thing we are going to do is to relate these two tables. And how we do that is to use a relationship. So to get to the relationship, what you'll do is to click on the Database Tools tab. You click on the Database Tools tab and click on relationship, and that is just fine. So click on the first one, hold down the control key and click on the second one, and just add them to the relationships window there, and it's just fine. I like to use an analogy to explain primary and foreign key. The analogy I normally use is when a president visits another country, okay? It means that there are two presidents in that country, but one president is actually the president of that country. What it means is, if Mr. Vladimir Putin goes to the White House to visit Barack Obama, well, then we have two presidents in the White House, right? It sounds funny. There will be two presidents in the White House. But if there are two presidents in the White House, one is a foreign one, and the other one is a primary one, right? So primary key is a primary key for that particular table, and foreign key is a primary key somewhere else, just like Putin is a key, a primary key in Russia, but not in the United States. So in the United States of America here, he'll be a foreign key. So we have departments and we have employees. So how do you relate this? So simply drag the primary key to its foreign key, corresponding foreign key in the other table. So just drop it there, enforce referential integrity, and you create. Okay, so what we need to do is to close the objects before we can create the relationship. So let's get back here in the relationship, just drag and drop in the corresponding name, enforce referential integrity. This I'll explain after now. So what we are creating is a relationship, a one to many relationship, meaning that one department to many employees, in one department many employees. It makes some sense, because in a company we have about 10 employees or even more in one department. But you cannot have one employee. It's not normal to have one employee several departments. So This is how you create the relationship between these two tables. Okay, so in the next tutorial, in part two, we are now going to discuss how to write this query to be able to join these two tables and get the relevant information. I'd like to thank you for viewing, and please click on the subscribe button if you've not already done so. If you've already subscribed, thanks a lot, thumbs up to you, and please like my video. Leave your comments, tell me what you want me to do right, tell me what you don't understand, and rest assured that I'll be there to answer your questions and respond to your comments. Once again, I'd like to thank you for viewing.